Good morning, students.
In the previous class, we have discussed about the features of planning, right? In the last class, we have discussed various features of planning. Today, let us discuss about what are the limitations. We all know that in any field or any area or any activity, any process, anything it may be, if there is a benefit from certain things, certain processes or certain activities, that do have some limitations, right? That do have some drawbacks. There is no doubt that planning is very, very important for the organization, and it leads for the success of the organization. We all know it, right? Because without planning, we cannot go or we cannot do the activities which have been intended to be do like that one, right? That's why planning gives us the way. Planning provides us the route that how can we achieve the organizational goals. Without that proper planning, we cannot achieve the organizational goals properly, right? Or it may be successfully. We can do any activity. Say for example, if I want to write you something, you can write something. But if you are prepared earlier, right? If you are prepared earlier, you can compare the marks, the scores you score in your examination, which is being already scheduled, and the examination, or even we can take it as a test, surprise test, what we call, right? You can compare the scores. So if I give the same questions in surprise test and the test which is being given as per the schedule, you can score more marks in the scheduled test or examinations, because you know, you prepare for that one, right? So but for the surprise test, we are not being prepared. That's why the scores will be low. That's why planning is very, very important for the organizations, as I told you, right? But planning has some limitations. It is also having some drawbacks. Let us see what are the various drawbacks of the plan. The first one, planning leads to rigidity. So what is this rigidity means? See, every time we plan, we fix a frame for our work, right? Say for example, so I will take as your students the example of a college, right? We prepare timetable, right? We prepare the timetable. It is the planned schedule on which we run our classes, right? ನಮ್ಮ ಒಂದು ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಆ ಒಂದು ಶೆಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ಪ್ರಕಾರನೇ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಟೈಮ್ ಟೇಬಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಶೆಡ್ಯೂಲಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಟೇಬಲ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ 9 to 10 ಆನ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್, 10 to 11, 11 to 11:15 ಬ್ರೇಕ್, 11:15 to 12:15, 12:15 to 1:30 ಹಾಫ್ ಆನ್ ಅವರ್ ಲಂಚ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ವೆನ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ರಿಜಿಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಚೇಂಜ್. Say for example, what if I extend my time? Say for example, your classes will be let off at 4 o'clock, right? 4 o'clock your classes will be let off, and you are being prepared that mentally, physically, that you will be leaving the college at 4 o'clock. So it is being prepared. We have been fixed that we will leave at 4 o'clock, and at 4:05 I am having my bus. So what if I will continue my class up to 4:30, right? If the plan is being prepared, every employee, every organization has to go according to the plan. We cannot make changes. That is what the rigid means. Means it is being constant. We cannot change, we cannot alter the plans. That is what planning leads to the rigidity means. Means plans are constant. They are being fixed. We cannot make any changes. The second one also is related to the work planning. See, planning may not work in a dynamic environment. Dynamic environment, that is changing environment. We have been prepared a plan. What we assume is the things will be like this. This will be the scenario, right? So according to that one, we prepare a plan. But all of a sudden, some changes will be happened. There is a lack of supply of materials, it may, right? There will be a huge demand. There will be lack of supply. There will be collapse of demand, economic crisis, anything it may be. Say for example, as per today's scenario, what I will do is, I plan for selling 1000 units of some XYZ product. 1000 units of XYZ product. That's why what I am planning is, I will produce 1500 units of the product. 1500 units of the product. But automatically, you are seeing the demand for the masks in this COVID-19 season. So there is lack of supply for the masks, right? You are being seen. So like that, what happens is some changes may happen, right? So what I have planned is, I will sell 1000 units. That is my target, that is my objective, and I am prepared for producing 1500 units. So what if there is a sudden demand for my product and the demanded units will be 10,000, 20,000, 1 lakh. So, as per my plan, I cannot produce that much of the products or that much of the units. Means, the plans have to be prepared in such a way that we can develop an alternative plan so that we can cope up with the situations. Now, the situations na sari maadkobeku athara na plan na maadbeku. So, ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇದೊಂದು ಟೈಮ್ ಫ್ರೇಮ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀವಿ, ಇದೇ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ಇಷ್ಟೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಬಂದ ಇದಿಷ್ಟೇ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಬಟ್ ಏನಿದೆ, ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್, ಇವರ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಟೇಬಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅಪ್ ಟು 4 o'clock. ಸೊ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಶೆಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗಿವನ್ ಸೋ ದಟ್ ಸೋ ಇಫ್ ನೀಡೆಡ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಟು 5 o'clock, ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಟು 6 o'clock ಆರ್ ಇವನ್ 3 o'clock. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾನಿಂಗ್ ಮೇ ನಾಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಡೈನಾಮಿಕ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಚೇಂಜಿಂಗ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಆನ್ ಚೇಂಜಿಂಗ್. So today the demand is 1000, day after tomorrow the demand may collapse to 100, but even after one day the demand may be 10,000, like that. So the plans will not work in a dynamic environment. Then plans reduces creativity. So although, as I told you, plan is a creative process, planning is a creative process, it is an innovating process, it's a mind exercise. As we think, as we sit for developing plan, we will get different ideas. But in an organization, the planning process, the plans will be prepared by the top management, right? The plans will be prepared by the top management, so that here the sentence means planning reduces creativity, means it will reduce the creativity of lower level people, middle level and executive level people. ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಏನು ಕೆಲಸ ಇರಲ್ಲ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಟಾಪ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಯು ದ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ಸ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾನ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ದೇರ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟಿವಿಟಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಿಡಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟಿವ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್. ದೆನ್ ಪ್ಲಾನಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯೂಜ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್, ರೈಟ್? ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಆಸ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್, ಪ್ಲಾನಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಸೈಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಇದೊಂದು ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಸೈಸ್ ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಥ ಏನಿದೆ, ನಾನು ನನ್ನ ಮೈಂಡಿಗೆ ದುಡ್ಡು ಕೊಡೋ ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆ ಇಲ್ಲ. But it involves huge cost, because when I need to plan, I have to collect various data. I need various sources so that I can prepare my plan. I need some market information. Market information will not come directly to mine, come directly to me, right? So I have to appoint a person so that he can collect the information from the market and give it to me. Information related to the supplier, information related to the political environment, right? So in the business environment, you need, we will study the the different types of environment which are being associated with the business. So from all sources I need the information. The information is not free of cost. It will have some cost that the organization has to bear. That's why planning involves huge costs. Planning is a time consuming process. Definitely, because as I told, planning is a thinking process. So when I am saying I am thinking something, that is I am consuming my time, right? So because no plan will suddenly come into mind. So we have to think, we have to develop alternative process of actions, right? That's why planning consumes the time. Then the last one, planning does not guarantee the success, definitely. So plan is something through which we can reduce the uncertainties. So we can save ourselves up to some extent, right? In the plan maadodrindale naavu namanna alpa salpa save maadkobodu, but planning does not provide the guarantee that the success of the organization is guaranteed if you follow this plan, right? Planning antakkantadhu enide namage bege bege planning antakkantadhu, but enide planning namage full proof alla. Say for example, we insure ourselves. Say for example, a vehicle insurance. ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ತೀವಿ, ನಮ್ಮ ಬೈಕ್ ಕಳ್ತಾನ ಆಯಿತು, ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಯಿತು, ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ದುಡ್ಡು ಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ, ನಾವು ದುಡ್ಡು ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ, ಬಟ್ ಹಾಗೆ ಆಗುತ್ತಾ? ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸೇಫ್ಟಿ ಮೆಷರ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಸೇಫ್ಟಿ ಪ್ರಿಕಾಷನ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಅದು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಕೂಡ ಏನಿದೆ, ಸುಮಾರಷ್ಟು ಪ್ಲಾನ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ದಟ್ ಮೇ ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ದ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್, ಬಟ್ ನೋ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಯು 100% guarantee that if you follow this plan, you will get the success. We have to tell you people that you keep on reading, you keep on studying, practice the writing skills, right? Practice some communication skills, but no one is 100% perfect, right? So like that one, plan does not also guarantee the success, right? So these are some of the points related to the limitations of the plan. First one leads to duty, means we have to work in a fixed environment. Second one, we cannot change the plans. We cannot prepare a foolproof plan in a changing environment. It reduces the creativity of lower level people. It involves cost, it's time consuming, and it will not guarantee the success of the organization. So this is related to the limitations of planning. In the next class, we will discuss about the process of planning, how we will prepare our plans. Thank you.